Just quickly, I'm K.U. Suratia. I'm faculty member at IIT Guwahati. I work in the area of HCI, specifically in ICT 4D, and we have just started working in virtual reality and input interaction methods. So given the time frame we have, 10 minutes, I'll quickly brief you about some of the projects that we are doing currently in Assam. And I'll be majorly talking about two projects, which are very recent projects we have started. The first one is Pragati, which is basically trying to train community health workers in Assam. And the second one is Swasthyaa, which is basically an ICT-supported complete ecosystem for tuberculosis care. These projects are funded by Government of India, and we are collaborating with WHO, Government of Assam, and National Health Mission. I'll very briefly touch upon what we are doing, and maybe if someone has some questions, we can certainly talk about them later. Okay, just a lot of people may not sure whether you are aware about health workers, but just to give you a quick idea about health workers are sort of people who communicate health education and act as a mediator between the doctors and the community members. So sometimes they become health professionals and support them in escorting to health centers and so on. So currently what we see is there are a lot of challenges, loopholes into the health worker ecosystem. So first is they are not sufficiently trained. And even if they are trained, the methods are very passive in nature, which includes a verbal method where someone, a trainer comes and speaks about it and then expects all the health workers to learn by themselves. So what happens, and there are other problems, I'll not go into the detail of it, but because of this, these problems, the health workers are not able to gain health education or training, which they are supposed to communicate to the community members. And because of this, the healthy communities, as in, this results basically in unhealthy practices in the rural communities. So what we have done is, we have basically created a, designed a low-cost head-mounted display based immersive virtual interface that is to train health workers. So so one of the good part of this project is it's not a passive set of modules, just audiovisual modules where health workers would come and learn or listen to the modules, but here what we are trying to do it is giving them certain tasks that they would be performing various set of activities. So you can see over here, not sure you can see, but the health workers would actually take the baby out of the womb, perform those activities onto the virtual environment. The second, where the health workers would clean the newborn, and health workers would make the pregnant woman sleep on the chair and so on. So those kind of activities they will be performing, and the idea is that to have hands-on practice-based approach rather than just a passive module. So the other interesting part of these project as we wanted to scale the project is the solution works with a head-mounted display as well as in a 2D mobile application as well as in a 360-degree environment. So we wanted to ensure that such solutions are not limited to training center, which ideally would have the cheap head-mounted displays, which Government of Assam has agreed to provide, but it also goes on to the field where health worker can take it onto the field, show it to the community members, and you know, act as a third person, specifically in the issues related to family planning, sex, and pregnancy, which they are very shy about. So can mobile phone become a third person where information related to sex and so on could be communicated to rural communities through these mobile interventions? And also it works when health worker is at home, they can also learn themselves sitting at the home. Okay, there are other part, I'll not go into the videos right now, but the other part of the solution is about a peer learning platform, which is purely audio and visual based peer learning platform where health workers all across Assam can update whatever their learnings are, whatever the information that they want to share it with people. So it's purely audio-visual interface where health workers would record an audio and upload it over the system, which is uploading is not based on their own network data, but network which is supported on the health centers itself. Yeah, so currently what we are, what stage we are in, we have done some studies with 60 health workers. So this is one snapshot of when we were doing evaluation. So we had done studies with some 60 health workers and the results are encouraging. So we are doing the next study in January, which is with 500 health workers and trying to see if we can increase the learnability and memorability of the health contents, specifically in maternal and child health, and see if it can create an impact of it. So this is the first project. We are still on the project. We still have one more year, 1.5 years on the project and hoping to see some good results. But the idea is that we deploy the complete the solution across Assam which would have more than 50,000 health workers. Okay, the second one is, the earlier speaker had already talked about TB. The second one is a project that we are doing on called Swasthyaa, which is again complete tuberculosis care, what we call it. So very quickly, the kind of challenges that the TB ecosystem has in India, first is the poor referral system. That means if I am a citizen and I may be a prospective TB patient, there is a process that a health worker refers to the health system that I may be a tuberculosis patient. Second is tracking of initial and retreatment defaulters. That means I enroll that means if I am identified as a TB patient, one option is that I don't even enroll into the government schemes. How do I track if I don't enroll? And eventually the person would get into a very serious stages of tuberculosis, or I start consuming medicines, but I don't complete the course. So then again, I go from category 1 to category 2 or 3 patients. So then how do we track these initial and retreatment defaulters? Third is the DOTS consumption. How do we real-time track DOTS consumption? 99DOTS has been doing amazing work onto that. There are two major other things which are a part of project is all the health centers, even public and private, they are completely disconnected. Specifically in Assam, where most of the population migrates from one place to another place for work. So if the health centers are not connected, the patient is enrolled into the program starting from the starting of the program itself. So, and most often they don't even enroll into the program because they are daily wage workers. And second is all these problems lead basically to any kind of preventive measures which are often delayed. By the time the health administrator would know that the patient is not part of the patient is not taking consuming medicines or not even registered into the DOTS program, it's too delayed, and eventually all the government schemes become ineffective. So what we have currently proposed, which we are currently in the development stage, so it's a complete ecosystem which will connect patients, family members, all the health providers, which includes medical officers, TB control units, STS senior technical supervisors, health workers, DOT providers, all the IS officers who are at the top managing the National Health Mission and so on, and also connect all the private clinics and the government clinics. So what new we are doing, just to give you a very quick overview, is we are using this multi-technology platform which includes web, mobile and IVR system based on the technology literacy of the users. That means if the health worker has specific technology literacy or the patient does not have at all any technology literacy, then can we use different platforms such as IVR, giving a missed call or just calling and entering a particular number to it. So, and also we have introduced one incentive-based system, which means it's not a purely monetary incentive-based system, but the moment health worker ensures that the patient is tracked, the health worker would get a 5 rupees of mobile recharge. And similar way, if every 15 days and every 1 month, if the medicine consumption of the patient is appropriate, as in regular, then the patient would again get some every 15 days, they would get 5 rupees of a mobile recharge. So that is, in a way, we are trying to incentivize and see if that works out to make sure that everyone is on the platform. Very quickly, I'll touch, as in how the whole ecosystem works. So if some patient is if a citizen is a prospective patient, that means he's coughing or has some symptoms of a tuberculosis, he's basically referred. He goes to the health center where the health worker, or we call it A&M, auxiliary nurse midwife, refers her on the digital system and then asks the patient to visit the lab technician where the checkup will be done to see whether the patient is a prospective, the prospective patient converts into patient or not. So one of the major drawback in the current TB ecosystem is there is no data that how many prospective patient actually converts into the patient. That's very critical because they want to measure what location these people come from and what are the age group and other parameters. That becomes very critical for TB ecosystem. So that is what one we are measuring. Second, once if the patient is identified if the prospective patient is identified as a patient, he's requested to enroll into the DOTS program. Again, incentives comes over here. The moment patient enrolls into the DOTS program to the patient as well as the health worker. Then the medicine consumption is typically tracked by the IVR system that we are currently developing. And then all the patient family members and medical officers and all the related stakeholders through the TB ecosystem are into the loop, knowing what the patient is doing exactly at that point of a time. And and once the whole 6 months patient system is over, then we hope that the patient gets cured. So I'm just completing. So I'm almost done, yeah. So we are hoping that we'll launch this in one district, which is a district of 3,000 tuberculosis patients, but hopefully we are starting with 500. The government wants it to start with directly 3,000, which seems to be a little bit impossible. But anyway, so that's the current ecosystem. Some other, just one last slide that we are also sort of discussing with USC on collaborating on how we can predict whether the prospective or the patient would default or not, and how we can predict whether there are any whether the health workers would be motivated enough to be a part of the ecosystem, because motivation is one of the major challenges. So thank you. I'm sorry I took maybe a minute or so.